All right. Obviously, you have to start the video by taking a swing off of this diabetic poison. But it sure as hell is a sweet poison. Bloody hell. So, to the point of the video, these things. What are these things? Well, I'm pretty sure you would recognize these as cassettes. Namely, cassettes from Indonesia. Which I bought from a vendor a couple of weeks prior to this video. I believe it was like 2 months or something. So, when I bought these cassettes, I was very optimistic. I just thought that, okay, Indonesia, poor country, you know, big deal. Maybe it's just the fact that cassettes are just type 1 tape, but, you know, sound alright. It is true that this is type 1 tape. As you can see, it's very cheap type 1 tape because it's not even brown. It's like blackish brown. And the reasoning for this logic was because a lot of cassettes in the 90s, which were manufactured still, were manufactured in Russia, Poland, and overall Eastern Europe and Middle Europe. You know, the cheaper parts of Europe. So this is the fragile, but 9-inch nails, obviously. As you can see, here we have the Polish pressing, Universal Music Polska. And I can tell you that these cassettes sound real nice. This is a very good pressing. Somewhat rare pressing as well. This actually came with a cardboard slipcase, which I do not have here, but I do own them. But the case is really, really big. Or just 2 cassettes, it's like I have a feeling that the thing is just gonna get extremely worn and broken if I'm just gonna, you know, store it with the rest of my cassettes. So that's why these two are standing as loosely as this. So there are other novelties, obviously, to getting cassettes from Indonesia, because you can see that you have your price stickers and whatever. You have these nice shiny hologram universal stickers. You know, things that overall drag you to buying these. And also the fact that a lot of like very mainstream mass-produced things, like with teeth, for example, there you can mostly see them as CDs here in Western countries. The vinyl pressing was only released in, I believe, the US, and there was a European pressing, but they're really expensive. So, you know, the cassette, it's kind of a, it has a novelty in the midst of all of that. In the only countries where a cassette pressing was released was Indonesia, obviously, because here you can see Universal Music Indonesia, Malaysia, and I believe there were a few others. Can't remember which ones. I mean, you can just look that information up if you are really interested. Do you know, it's a nice packaging. You have your, you have a full artwork here, even on the front. You know, looks really nice. It's really tempting, and it tempted me with its $4 price. But with the price so good, you can't help but think that it's too good to be true. For all of these cassettes, plus 1 cassette which I will be showing you later on, I just paid for like around 40 euros, including shipping. This being the most expensive one, even though I'm not sure is this too rare at all. Obviously this is the March of the Pigs cassette. I thought that you could only get this with the Australian pressing, which is extremely rare. It's like a slipcase. kind of ordeal. Obviously, I don't have it because no one is selling it, and if someone is going to sell it, it's going to be so damn expensive. I'm gonna feel just bad thinking about buying it. So here you can see the track listing. It's the same on both sides. You know, the same deal with the Australian pressing, except that this one was significantly cheaper. This is sold to me as well as this is sold to me as near mint. You can see there's a bend mark over there. There's some scuffs both of the corners. So obviously the seller isn't the most trustworthy person. Got this off of a Discog seller who sells Indonesian cassettes, obviously. So, I'm going to tell you right now that the sound quality on all of these three cassettes is less than acceptable. They sound really compressed, really muddy, very bass heavy, and with an album like Songs for the Deaf, which is already known for being a loud album, you know, loudness wars and whatever, it sounds really horrible. I do not enjoy listening to this fantastic album on this cassette at all. But these are all, like as you can see here, this cassette is quite worn. You can see it from the label. You can see it has water damage. It is it's been bent a million times, and you know the spine is bleached compared to this inlay and to this cover art here, which means that it's been sitting on the sun or sitting on someone's car or, you know, the streets or whatever. So that makes me think that, is this cassette just worn, just, you know, being played a couple of times, and, you know, what about these other cassettes? This one was sold to me as near mint, and, you know, this one actually sounds acceptable. This is actually pretty good. But it's not as good as an MP3 file, which tells you quite a lot about the quality. I mean, it's muddy, yes, as well, but not as nearly as muddy as this one. And with teeth, this one just sounds like a bad quality MP3 rip. I mean, I guess that's the theme here. But you know, with a fairly cheap price and temptating formats and whatever, I decided to give this a try. And my slight disappointment was so slight that the only backlash I'm ever going to have about it is this video. So, going on to the main focus of this video, here I have, still in bubble wrap, a completely new cassette, still in shrink. You can see there is a price sticker. You can see that there is some weird Indonesian sticker thing on the back there. And yeah, this is sealed. You can see there is that seam there. You know, a starting thing over there. And obviously, judging from the title of this video, I'm going to be opening this. So let's just do that. Alright. So, due to this cassette being sealed, I got this. It was in a bundle with those other cassettes. The reason I have kept this one sealed is because I thought that the price would go up for whatever reason. And I got this for like 8 euros. And if I look at the prices right now, they're not that significantly different. So if I ever have the unbearable urge to get a sealed copy of this album once again, you know, that is very much approachable. So it is a rare opportunity to open a sealed cassette in the year 2018. In any case, anyhow, so, you know, sharing this moment with you is going to be something special, especially since I'm trying to figure out how am I gonna open this. Okay, got something started there. Okay. Oh, there we go. Okay. Ooh. Cheap cellophane. Here's the price sticker. Harika Music. Shout out to them. And you know I cannot pay like in one piece. Shit. Well, whatever. So here we have this sticker on top. I have no idea what is that supposed to be or what is that supposed to mean. I mean, there we have a prod and NPWB/TH. Prod obviously probably means production or something, production date. No idea what that is supposed to be, but it's kind of... sticker was kind of bent. I mean, it was underneath the shrink wrap and it's bent. Doesn't make sense, really. Okay, so... here we have it. The cassette. Looks like every single one of the cassettes which I have featured before. You know, Universal Music. This one doesn't even have the track titles or the artist, which is incredible. And here you can see that the cassette already has some scuffs in it. I mean, I just opened this. This is like as mint as you can get a cassette from Indonesia. Let's take a look at the inlay. Oh, what is this? This is like some advertisement thing. That's cool. Straight from the year 2001. There is like a ringtone service. Video cut off because I didn't have enough space on my phone, but back to this! Because this is a blast to the 2001, because this cassette was released in the year 2001. Okay, so here you can see 50 Cent's In The Club. The name is spelled wrong. Stevie Wonder, Audioslave, Black Eyed Peas. Well, there's like a notation over there. Focus, you bloody thing. Okay, don't focus. Whatever. So here we have more. Universal 10, top 10 oldies and top 10 80s rock. Okay. You know, that's always interesting. There's like instructions for you. And this is cool. This is cool because this is really... This is in actuality a relic, like, from 17 years. This is a relic 17 years in the past. And I'm handling it like it's a completely new thing. This is truly, truly magnificent. But okay, here we have these liners, which are really... this is really thick. This is really heavy. You can see that. That is a lot of paper over there. That is a lot. I mean, let's see if I can see through this. I mean, here you can see it's bent to shit. I mean, it's so pressed to the cassette, you can see that there's like bend marks and whatever. So let's see if I have the ability to fold this. So, I mean, there's like even the thing that folds from here. Like, holy shit. So here we have some cool images. You know that there's the front cover image. And we have lyrics for every single song. Let's take a look at the back. Second time the video cut off. Okay, let's wrap this up quick. So yeah, the backside, more imagery and more whatnot. But however, because this cassette itself is in complete mint condition, I want to review the sound. Because, as I mentioned before, with the rest of the cassettes, a plausible theory is that they're so worn, they're so used, that that's the reason why some of them sound really, really bad. So, you know, I'm gonna give this one a little bit of a try. You know, see if it's up to any kind of quality. As you see, there's no A or B side on this cassette either. Bloody hell. I mean, Universal Music Indonesia doesn't have any standards, it seems, so I'm kind of paranoid. As you can see, there's even the tabs still intact, like the recording tabs. Are you supposed to break these off, or is it like, if you don't like the cassette, you can just record on top of it? I don't know. I mean, it's like... Right, so, give this tape... What the fuck? No. So I gave this tape a little bit of a listen. And surprisingly enough, it sounds alright. Sounds alright, to say the least. But one thing I found, especially on side A of this tape, is the fact that the right audio channel is significantly louder than the left audio channel. And I tried playing the other side of the tape a little bit, and I noticed that the same problem persisted there as well. And I checked with another tape, was it my tape head? No, it wasn't. I have no clue. It's just the way it is, I guess. It's not that it's louder, really. It's more compressed. Like, the left channel sounds like tinny, almost. So that there's a difference in timber as well. So, you know, that's just a thing. That's just a thing worth mentioning, I believe. So, yeah, especially the first track sounded really good, like Mein Herz brennt, I believe that's how it's pronounced, with its string sections or whatever, sounded fantastic. But after, like, the guitars and everything kicked in, it was clearly noticeable. So kind of disappointing, but I'm pretty sure I'm able to even it out with an equalizer or something. But yeah, that's it for this time.